The next topic is photorespiration. Photorespiration, this is first time observed by Deccan scientist in 1955 in the soybeans. What he observed that in the presence of light, plants are taking oxygen and they are releasing carbon dioxide. They are taking oxygen and they are releasing carbon dioxide. So this is similar to our respiration. In our respiration also, all the animals, they take oxygen and they release the carbon dioxide. That type of process is observed in soya beans by Deccan. So what is that process? Generally we know that in the Calvin cycle, first step in Calvin cycle, what happens? RuBB, ribulose bisphosphate, is going to absorb the carbon dioxide in the presence of Rubisco. Rubisco act as a carboxylase and enters into Calvin cycle. Synthesis of sugars, everything is going on. So it is Calvin cycle. Okay, produces the phosphoglyceraldehyde. Okay, this is the Calvin cycle. In the Calvin cycle, what is Rubisco is, which is present in the leaves abundantly, that is acting as a carboxylase. Means it act the, it is affinity to bind with the both oxygen as well as the carbon dioxide. It can bind with the oxygen and carbon dioxide. But when it binds with the carbon dioxide, then only there is a synthesis of sugars and everything takes place. But when it is going to bind with the carbon dioxide, that process is known as photorespiration. Then when it is going to behave like that, that is very important. So when the concentration is RuBB, ribulose, Rubisco behavior is changed, when the conditions are changed. So what are the conditions? If the temperature is high or more, and concentration of oxygen is increased. So these are the two conditions. In these two conditions, Rubisco act as a oxygenase. Instead of binding with the carbon dioxide, it is going to bind with the oxygen. RuBB generally bind with the carbon dioxide. But in the case of concentration of oxygen is more and temperature is high in the atmosphere, then our RuBB bind with the oxygen and it is Rubisco. Here in this reaction, Rubisco acting as an oxygenase and it produced the phosphoglycolate and glycolate. So these are the two carbon containing compounds. So that is the reason first compound in the photorespiration, which is formed phosphoglycolate, that contain the glycolate, that contains the two carbon atoms. So that is the reason photorespiration is also known as C2 cycle. In this cycle, there are three cell organelles are involved: chloroplast and peroxisomes and mitochondria. So when our Rubisco act as a oxygenase, it bind with the Rubisco, RuBB bind with the oxygen and it undergo the process of photorespiration. So in general photosynthesis, what is happening? This is C2 cycle. In general, photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide is taken. Carbon dioxide is taken and O2 is released. But whereas in the photorespiration, in this photorespiration, oxygen is taken and CO2 is released, like our general respiration. In our respiration process, we take the oxygen and we release the carbon dioxide. So that is the reason we call this process is a respiration. We compared with the respiration. And why we are saying the photo means in the presence of light only. This process takes place in the presence of light only. When the when concentration of oxygen is more in the atmosphere, our RUBB bind with the oxygen. Okay, our RUBB bind with the oxygen. So for this photorespiration takes place in three cell organelles, that is chloroplast, peroxisomes and mitochondria. First acceptor, instead of binding with the carbon dioxide, it is going to bind with the oxygen. It is enzyme is ribulose rubisco carboxylase. Rubisco act as a oxygenase. It act as a oxygenase and produce the phosphoglycolate, and then phosphoglycolate diffuses and enters through the plasma, enter through the connections, that is plasmodesmata. Through the plasmodesmata it enters into the peroxisomes, glycolate, and it, by the oxygenation it transforms into glyoxylate, and then transamination. By the transamination process it is going to form the glycine. So this cycle is also known as glycolate cycle also. Okay, this is first compound is two carbon compound is complex is compound is produced, that is the reason we are calling it as a C2 cycle, and glycine is produced in the peroxisomes. First in the chloroplast our rubisco enzyme is there, and it is instead of taking carbon dioxide it is taking the oxygen. If it is take the carbon dioxide, that is Calvin cycle, but it is taking oxygen. Instead of forming glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, it is forming phosphoglycolate that enters into the peroxisomes and transform into glycolate. Then by the oxygenation process it is going to glyoxylate, it forms the glyoxylate. Then by the amination process, transamination process, it forms the glycine. This glycine enters into the mitochondria. Mitochondria by the decarboxylation. This is important, decarboxylation process. Because what we said that in the photorespiration, in the presence of light, plants are taking oxygen and they are releasing carbon dioxide. At the end of this process, the carbon dioxide is going to be released. So by the decarboxylation process, so ammonia is released and carbon dioxide released, and this serine is formed. So again this serine diffuses into the peroxisomes, and this then it transform into pyruvate and glycerate. That glycerate again enters into the chloroplast, it forms the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. It is three compound. So from the mitochondria, glycine transform into serine again enters into the peroxisomes, it transform into pyruvate glycerate, and glycerate enters into the chloroplast, finally it forms the 3-PGA and regeneration of RUBB. Here the regeneration is taking place, but there is no synthesis of sugars or ATP is not synthesized. Instead of it is not synthesized, but it is utilizing the energy. In our general respiration, energy releasing process is respiration, but whereas this photorespiration is energy taking process. Energy, by utilizing the energy, it is a, people say that it is a waste process in the plants, because it neither synthesizes the ATPs or sugars. Sugars or ATPs are not going to synthesize by this cycle. Okay, by this cycle we are not going to get any glucose or ATPs. So this is the waste process in the plants. Once again, photorespiration. Why we are saying that photorespiration? Plants, in the presence of light, they are taking oxygen and they are releasing carbon dioxide. For this, the process is going on in the three cell organelles: chloroplast, peroxisomes, and mitochondria. In this process, they are going to produce two carbon. Our Rubisco enzyme, Rubisco act as an oxygenase when the temperature is high and oxygen concentration is more. It combined with the RuBP and it forms the, instead of forming glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, it forms the phosphoglycolate and glycolate, and finally it releases the carbon dioxide. So this is releasing carbon dioxide is similar with the taking oxygen, and releasing carbon dioxide is similar with the respiration. So that is the reason we are saying this we are comparing with the respiration. And this photorespiration, if the photorespiration takes place in the plants, what happened? Instead of forming the glucose molecules or sugars, it is a waste process. There is no synthesis of sugars or ATPs are not going to synthesize. So the rate of photosynthesis is decreased. Rate of photosynthesis is decreased. So in the C3 plants, so this process is in C3 plants, it is very common. In the C3 plants, it is very common. But whereas C4 plants, the plants which produce in the carbene cycle, in the carboxylation, first stable compound is oxaloacetic acid. So those plants, C4 plants, they avoid this photorespiration by the special anatomy, that is Crans anatomy. They have the Crans anatomy. So there is a spatial separation is there. So that helps them to avoid this process. Okay. So C3 plants, they cannot avoid this photorespiration process. If the oxygen concentration is high in the temperature, high in the atmosphere, ultimately our Rubisco bind with the oxygen. Once again, photorespiration is it is also known as C2 cycle, glycolate cycle. So in this, Rubisco enzyme, instead of binding carboxylase carbon dioxide, it is binding with the oxygen. Why RuBP is binding with the oxygen? Because oxygen concentration is high, and in this process we are getting carbon dioxide. Okay, thank you.